What's in the box?
I'm going to open the magic box. Okay. So these are some tools that might have been used around the time period where we were shooting our show.
The 1940s.
The 1940s.
When we shot Ratched.
That was exactly when we did it. Really. Okay. Does anybody want to take a gander and a guess as to what this is used to do? What do you think that does? It's a ball cutter. No, I'm just kidding. It's not. It's what it looks like to me, but.
It's a lorgnette. Yeah.
What do you think? Yeah, see? Little prongs in there.
It's really a little scary. It's got some.
It's not dental.
It's a cutter.
Throat?
Uh-huh. Yes, Judy.
Is it a tonsillectomy thing?
Yes, Sharon.
What is
it? It's a tonsillotome, which is AKA a Swiss tonsil guillotine.
Ooh. Right. Because they stab the tonsils.
It would be
with
a partial, yes, or complete excision of the tonsils.
Right.
They would put the tonsil in the hole, then they would use the fork to fork it in place. Once they had the tonsil forked in place and inside the hole, they would slide the guillotine.
Ugh.
The tonsil would then stay on the fork so the patient wouldn't swallow it.
Oh.
The doctor would then inspect the tonsil and throw it away. Do you have your tonsils?
I don't.
Do you have your tonsils?
I do.
Do you?
I do.
I do too. Okay.
It's a lorgnette.
No, you don't know about the other thing.
Oh, I can't get it out. Oh, well, whatever. Oh.
See, it sort of weirdly looks like a whistle from this angle.
Or a parrot.
A parrot?
Yeah, a parrot.
What do you think?
It wouldn't be anything to do with the cervix.
It is not.
Okay, great.
All of these fold for women's anatomy, or are they for?
I'm not going to give away a clue, Sharon. They are just, they're all instruments used.
So it's that
in the 40s.
Kind of.
Yes, there you
thing,
go.
May I?
Yes. Now, what's happening at the mouth of that thing? Why does everyone want to swing it? It's so, Judy was swinging it.
Yeah.
So look at what's happening at the top there. Uh huh. What are you seeing?
Oh, it's...
Yeah, something's gonna cut
some out. Mouth thing again. Okay, it's a mouth thing.
It might be a mouth thing. Or in the vicinity.
In the vicinity of the mouth.
It well, has to have...
Nose?
I mean, no, I'm sorry, in the...
It's a nose hair clipper.
No, if you could get that up your nose, I would be so
It has to go somewhere that has this kind of shape.
Uh-huh,
so it either
go.
Has to go
Sharon,
down
uh-huh.
the throat...
Sharon for the win again!
Or
she
up,
has a very high IQ, folks.
I said mouth.
You did
no,
begin
I'm
it, you did begin
just
it.
Say that.
You began it, you began it.
So if it was going down or
down.
Up...
Uh-huh.
It would
nasal
be
nasal scraper thing.
Okay, so it's an
adenoid.
Yes, Sharon.
Remover, right? Because it would have.
I'm just saying. I said nasal.
Because it would have to go in and up.
It's an instrument for the surgical excision of the adenoids. The device would go in through the patient's mouth, up through the back of the roof of the mouth where the adenoids are located. Once the doctor located the adenoids, the doctor would activate. Once again, we have a guillotine. Slice the adenoids off and pull them out through the back of the mouth.
Yes.
Thank you, Nurse Bucket.
Yucky.
Okay.
Well, that just looks mean.
It looks mean, but I like Judy to get the thing going, and then by the time we get to Sharon, it'll be completely figured out. Hey!
Broke it. I think I broke it.
Think about it. It's like a weird windmill.
I don't know.
Thing. Sharon, just, what is it? Because I know you're gonna know. Pushing tight on Sharon. Look at her thinking.
It has to be something. And this rolls and cuts it.
Uh-huh.
And then you have to do that. So is it to remove, like...
If you do this, I'm gonna freak out.
Is it to remove, like, moles and...
No, Sharon, it's not.
What is it?
Sharon, you're wrong.
Okay, give us that.
It's a ring cutter, okay?
Oh, it's a jewelry thing?
Well, it's used for cutting and removing rings from a traumatized or otherwise inflamed finger.
Oh.
I think Sharon almost had it, but, you know, because Sharon almost has it everything, by the way. Woman of the year. Sorry, I just need to keep hammering it home because it's worth hammering home. Nurse Bucket, thank you.
Indeed.
Okay, we now have...
Is that a douche thing?
You know what?
Is that what they're called?
Is that what they're called?
You just go, whoosh, and it
yeah,
does whatever.
When they go up the uterus and do that thing.
Yeah. Is it one of them? Is that what it is?
I don't think a douche goes in the uterus, does it?
Okay. What is it? It's not a douche.
Okay.
Okay.
Is it a very thick syringe?
Yes, but for what?
Oh, wow.
Where does it go?
Well, but it doesn't go there.
It's not a douche, for God's sake. It's a fan for a photo shoot.
It's an early nasal inhaler.
Yeah, oh. Mm-hmm. Nope.
Is it an enema?
Ear.
It's not. Pass it back to Judy.
Okay, here we go, Judy.
Judy, it is for the ear.
Really? Cleaning out the ear.
Yes! Judy, for the win!
Thank you.
Integral for the irrigation and the suction.
I was
for cleaning and treating infection.
Douche thing.
Believe it or not, a version of this is still used today. Not as a douche.
No.
Okay, thank you. Okay, it's a mirror, you guys.
In the middle of surgery.
In the middle of surgery, you're just like,
doctor.
Oh my God, I look so good.
That's the serial killer's mirror.
Oh, great. Well, this low angle is not so good. What do you think it is?
I think it's a bone saw.
Sharon Stone said it's a bone saw, and guess what? She's correct. Okay.
Knee, that's the knee thing for
No.
The thing?
No.
That's what
Oh, it goes together? Do they go together?
Yes. Before they had anesthetic. Oh,
that's for lobotomy.
This is what I used in the show.
Oh, that's right. I should.
Don't when the
tell
priest
them.
Got
Don't
it.
Tell them.
That's for the lobotomy,
this
right?
This is for lobotomy.
Yeah.
The ice pick. Right in the socket.
Mm. I thought they went in the temple.
We went up in the eye.
Oh.
Oh, through here.
Through here.
Through that soft spot under here.
And then everybody wants to hear it.
Really?
Yeah, they do.
They do. They
yep.
go in that soft spot
yep.
under
right
the
under there.
Right. Yeah.
Yeah.
And
boom. And is that everything? Oh.
It's a soft toy.
Oh, that's the
to keep the patient feeling.
It's a teeth guard.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So you don't bite off your tongue.
It's little Freddy.
Mm-hmm. I think Sharon knows what this one is, too.
We may have to try it on Judy or Sarah. I'm not sure.
Sharon got that one, too. Sorry, I'm weeping. I'm weeping. She did name this little... little Freddy.
Little Freddy.
Oh, my God, goodbye. I'm weeping. This is just a real representation of what would happen at work all the time. Little Freddy,
it's
AKA known as the rubber mouth gag, protected patients from biting off or swallowing his or her tongue during electroconvulsive therapy.
I have a feeling this is what they did to women like me my last life. That's why I know all these
In
things.
Your last life?
Yeah. I have a feeling that if they could do it to me this they life, would. They probably would.
And there you have it, folks.
And there you have it.
That's the button we needed. Oh, my God, I'm weeping. Little Freddy. I'll never get over it.